Oostburg man found guilty of double murder, Miller dropped from corporate name, guards assaulted at Lincoln Hills, charges pending. These and other local stories are coming up on this edition of Community News Review.
This is Community News Review, service WSCS-TV, news content provided by WHBL.
I'm Maddie Pfister, and this is Community News Review for Thursday, October 31st, 2019. Happy Halloween. It is good news for trick-or-treaters, or it is not good news for trick-or-treaters. A strong system is likely to keep many indoors tonight with a tricky combo of cold, wind, and snow. Light rain transitions to snow overnight, continuing through the midnight witching hour tomorrow. Winds of 15 to 25 miles per hour will combine with nearly freezing temperatures to make it feel close to 20 degrees. Advisories have been issued for Sheboygan County, and early forecasts put about an inch or two on the ground near Lake Michigan, while up to 5 inches of wet, heavy snows are possible in the western reaches. Those looking to launch a small business venture can get help thanks to virtual classroom sessions offered Saturday mornings in November by the Sheboygan County Economic Development Corporation and SCORE. Volunteers comprised of retired executives, and the first three sessions take place at South High beginning this Saturday morning, with the final session at Glass Coffee House Conference Center. And Colette Sizer, Sheboygan County's newest SCORE volunteer, organized the free classes, which would typically cost $35 each. Financing, legal issues, and digital marketing trends will be covered in the four sessions. For more information, contact the Sheboygan County Economic Development Corporation. A guilty sentence has been handed down in the case of Sergio Oca of Oostburg. Oka was on trial for about 3 weeks for a double murder from 2017. Yesterday, 43-year-old Oka was found guilty of first-degree reckless homicide. Oka killed two men, including his cousin in Oostburg home in July of 2017, though he said he shot them in self-defense. According to court documents, Oka was charged after police found his cousin Luis Garcia of Oostburg and Fernando Lopez of Milwaukee dead in a Oostburg home. They had been shot several times, and Oka turned himself in to Sheboygan police later and told them at the time he didn't mean to do what he did. According to some witnesses, the shooting was allegedly due to an argument over money. Oka's sentencing hearing is scheduled for January 14th, and he faces up to 80 years in prison and 40 years of extended supervision. Up to 10 more charges are pending after a series of disturbances at the state's juvenile prison at Lincoln Hills in September. Guards were injured in the altercations on September 27th and 28th at Lincoln Hills School for Boys. The Milwaukee Journal Sentinel reports that a third incident occurred on September 30th, according to a document submitted to Milwaukee County Health and Human Needs Committee ahead of its Wednesday meeting. One 20-year-old inmate, Avery Friedrich of Milwaukee, has been charged with a felony for allegedly strangling a guard with another guard's nose and was broken, and others suffered knee and shoulder injuries. Governor Evers has proposed closing Lincoln Hills in favor of smaller youth facilities focused on mental health. That plan will not happen until at least 2021. A bombshell in the brewing industry as part of a major corporation reorganization, Molson MillerCoors parent company is dropping Brewing and Miller from its brand name. The company will now be known as Molson Coors Beverage Company. According to a press release, Chicago will become the company's new North American operations headquarters, but several positions that were based throughout the United States will move to its Milwaukee office. Up to 500 positions will be eliminated elsewhere within the company. These changes are effective January 1st. Finally, Halloween may be known for trick-or-treating, costumes, and spooky decorations, but the scariest part of the holiday is the increased danger to motorists and pedestrians. According to the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, or NHTSA, 42% of those killed in motor vehicle crashes on Halloween night from 2013 to 2017 were crashes involving an impaired driver. Halloween is also one of the three top days for pedestrian injuries and fatalities each year. AAA offers the following safety reminders for pedestrians, motorists, and trick-or-treaters. Motorists, put it down. Avoid checking social media, checking text messages, and talking on the phone while driving. Drive slower through neighborhoods. Driving 5 miles per hour slower than the posted speed limit will give you an extra time to react to the children that dart out in front of you. Turn on your headlights to make sure you are more visible, even in the daylight. Drive sober. Nearly 40% of fatal crashes on Halloween night involve a drunk driver. Always designate a sober driver if you plan to drink any alcohol. For trick-or-treaters, stay on sidewalks and avoid walking in streets if possible. If there are no sidewalks, walk on the left side of the road facing traffic. Look both ways and listen for traffic before crossing the street. Cross streets only at the corner and never cross between parked vehicles or mid-block. Wear light-colored clothing or costumes with reflective material or tape for best visibility. For parents, walk with your children as they go door to door. Be sure to show them safe places to cross the street. Have children carrying a glow stick or flashlight to help them see and be seen by drivers. If using social media, post pictures and updates before or after you go out trick-or-treating to avoid being on your phone while walking or supervising children. Whether it is avoiding distractions or taking time to look before crossing the street, these are things both motorists and pedestrians can do to help keep everyone safe, said Nick Jarmuz, Director of Public Affairs for AAA. We want Halloween to be a fun evening, so be smart, be safe, and be seen. And that is our report for today. Join me again on Tuesday for more local news and information on Community News Review.
News content for this program provided by WHBL in cooperation with WSCS-TV.